Residents of Pandapiel village in Luzira sub-county have started relocating from their homesteads following the rising Lake Victoria waters, which has left access roads covered underwater. Most of the houses and property are immersed in the floods, leaving most of the residents stranded. Speaking to some of the small business owners in this community, the rising Victoria water level is a tragedy they have to flee from. The LC chairperson of Pandapiel, Tom Sange Joseph, says the water continues to rise each day and shows no signs of receding. He has called upon the Ministry for Disaster to intervene and relocate the most affected residents in his community.
Before embera je tuwangalira mwesa wazino mbera mbidala butono kubato sobola kuva uwo wadenga amazi gatulumbe latugasulamu no government kangume sono recho embera je tuli mwesa wazino mbera ya bunkenke era nafe tuandisabye government ebireko ningiri je tudukirira mu je tuyamba mu bizibugwa tebiraze.
This is the second community in Luzira to face flooding following the rising water levels of Lake Victoria. The Minister for Elderly Persons, Dominique Kidudu, traversed Bududa District to carry out the monitoring of government programs among the elderly populations in the district. During this tour, the minister urged older persons to embrace the culture of saving and discouraged land fragmentation. Kidudu was in company of the Bududa District Chairperson, Milton Kamoti, and other district technocrats as he inspected homes and projects for older persons in the two sub-counties. Kidudu inspected homes of elder persons that benefited from the SEG and PDM programs in the district. He also urged all those responsible for the Parish Development Model program to ensure that older persons receive their entitled share of 10%. This allocation, according to the Minister of Gender, is intended to support their development and enable them to access other government programs offering grants for the elderly.
I know how to get them for them. But I came here, I'm in Ugisha sub-region, I finished Busoga, and I've been impressed with Bududa. I have visited almost 10 beneficiaries, and I have seen that, yes, they have got these items and they are keeping them well. Yes, the parish development model, we have exceeded even the 10%.
Bududa LC5 chairperson Milton Kamoti appreciated government programs towards the elderly, among which is the Social Assistance Grant for Empowerment, SEG, which he says has made significant transformation of lives. Kamoti acknowledged the success registered by the elderly population through government programs. He however added that government should consider to add them funding.
We have seen people rearing cattle, we have seen people rearing pigs, we have seen improvement in coffee production and also bananas. So the program has been put to the proper use and people are happy. The only request they are making to the government is to increase the token, the appreciation, the money which they receive is minimum, though they appreciate it.
In Bududa, we started by going to the field, and we actually found out that the money for Sego, people have got the money and bought the animals, the others bought heifers, others bought pigs, others are in the farming.
A day after the army in DR Congo said it had thwarted an attempted coup involving several Americans and a British man, many in Kinshasa had questions on Monday about the attackers' motives and how they were able to access key government sites. The coup bid took place in the early hours of Sunday outside the residence of the economy minister, Vital Kamerhe, in the capital's northern Gombe area. The group then went to the Palais de la Nation that houses President Félix Tshisekedi's offices. Brandishing flags of Zaire, the name of the Democratic Republic of Congo under ex-dictator Mobutu Seseko, was overthrown in 1997. Shots were heard near the building, according to several sources. An army spokesperson later announced in a message broadcast on national TV that defense and security forces had stopped an attempted coup d'etat. Kamehe, who is a candidate for National Assembly President, and his family were unharmed, but two members of their security detail were killed. The attack aimed to assassinate the minister, his team said on Monday, showing reporters where the bullets had hit vehicles and his residence's walls and broken windows. While daily activity resumed as normal in Gombe on Monday, many questions remained unanswered. But in Washington, the State Department said it had no record of Malanga being a U.S. citizen. The State Department said it could not confirm the U.S. citizenship of two purported Americans in custody due to privacy laws. The United States nonetheless said it would cooperate to the fullest extent possible in the investigation and again condemned the coup attempt.